And shalom to the brothers, we the Hebrew Israelites. We come out here to prophesy like we do every week about America. America's on its way out of here. And that's a good thing.
That's right.
This country's about to be finished with. So we out here as men of the Lord, just like the Lord set up his prophets to predict the downfall of many other kingdoms, like Moses came out and prophesied against Egypt. You had many other prophets, Isaiah, Jeremiah, prophesied about the different kingdoms, Babylon. You also had the prophet Daniel. But anyway, what did the Lord do was set up his prophets to prophesy against the ruling kingdom on the earth that's not going with the laws and the statutes and his commandment. First of all, he wants his people to be set up as rulers on the planet Earth. So any other nation that's set up on the Earth, the Lord sets up his people, the one-third, the prophets of his people, to prophesy the downfall of the ruling kingdom that's going on right now. Right now, America is the ruling kingdom.
That's right.
It's the top kingdom on the planet Earth. So we come out here to do the work of the Lord, to prophesy the downfall of America, in which America is about to go out real soon, man. Destruction for this country is right around the corner. If you can't see that, then you'll see it when it happens, man. That's all I can really tell you. And I can guarantee you this, it's gonna happen in your lifetime, man. Mm-hmm. It says no man knows the time but the Father, but the Lord left plenty of signs in the Bible that tells you that we at that time, man. We read Matthew 24th chapter, read the whole book of Revelations. There's plenty of scriptures on it that'll tell you that we at that time for the end of this so-called white man, his rule, man. Brother got a scripture you gonna bring out, man.
The scripture I told you to get 1 and 20.
Proverbs
1 and 20. There's no prayer.
Yeah, you start from right there.
Alright, this is Proverbs chapter 1, verse 20. Wisdom crieth without, she uttereth her voice in the streets.
Yeah, wisdom crieth without, she uttereth her voice in the streets. Usually we out there in the streets. You see the brothers, we make videos out there. When we make them, man, we usually make them out there in the streets. Used to see us out there on 34th Street. And it says, wisdom crying, wisdom, we bringing out the word of this Bible. That's wisdom. So when you see us out there and we speak bold, just like the Lord spoke, it says, cry aloud, spare not. So that's right. What we do. We out there, you see us getting, we might come off bold, but that's how the Lord set us up to preach this word, man. That's how we supposed to be. Thus, we got this Bible. We know how to, the elders taught us how to break down this Bible through the Lord. If the Lord and the Spirit is dealing with us, so we got the right to bring this word out and be bold with it, man. We know what we're talking about. Read on.
Verse 21. She crieth in the chief place of concourse.
Yeah, that's what we do. We usually be out there we've known for being out there on 34th Street, Delancey Street. We used to be up there out on Fordham, but right there in the main street. It says the chief place of commerce. That's what it says.
No, she cried in the chief place of concourse.
Oh, concourse. Yeah, in the main streets out there. That's what we be out there prophesying this word, man. So everybody get heavy. So it's no excuses when the time comes for this destruction. You can't say that you never heard it, man. That's the reason why we out there on the chief places and on the highways and the byways preaching this word. I mean, I'm not knocking brothers that teach this word out there in the studio, but if you're not going out in the street, then you're not really doing the work. You have to be out there on the street,
right,
to bring this word out, man. And if you out there on the streets bringing this word out and you make videos in the studio, that's another thing. You got to keep pushing this word out. But the main thing the Lord wants us to do is be out there on the street. That's very important because that's how the Lord used to do it. The Lord used to be out there on the street. He didn't hide. He didn't hide in some little room, preaching in a room. He was always out there on the street, bringing the word out to the masses, man. And that's what he's setting us up to do. Go ahead, read on.
All right.
Something else you wanted to bring up?
Yeah, about the.
All right, hold that real quick.
Yeah, a quick precept about the highways. And the Lord said unto the servant, go out into the highways and edges, and compel them to come in, that my house may be filled.
Yeah, that's exactly. That's self-explanatory, man. That's self-explanatory about being out there on the highways and the byways preaching, man. Because this word is supposed to go out to everybody. But it's to wake up the elect. But we can't, nobody's out there with a sign on their head saying that I'm part of the one-third, I'm part of the elect. So we got to broadcast it out to everybody to fish in. That's why somebody get Jeremiah 16:16 real quick, too. And still hold what you got. Yeah, but that's what we out there doing. When you see us out there preaching on the streets, we out here trying to fish for the elect. We trying to wake up the brothers that's going to get this knowledge, man. And the two-thirds of you, you already know you're not going to get it. So that's so big, you know. You'll get this on the other side after you get destroyed on this side, man. We ain't out here trying to wake everybody up. We know we can't wake everybody up. It's only the Lord has an elect that he's dealing with, and that's who's going to get it. And that's what we out here for. But at the same time, yeah, we bring this word out. We warn people about the destruction that's going to come. That's all a part of it, man. It's all about the truth.
Okay. Jeremiah 16:16. Behold, I will send for many fishers.
Yeah. It says, behold, I will send for many fishers. And that's what we out here doing. We out here fishing for the elect. So when you see us out here preaching, that's what we're doing. We're fishing. We're fulfilling prophecy. Like it says in the book of Jeremiah, where the brother's reading from right now. That's what we out here doing. That's how you know that this Bible is the truth, man. And we fulfilling prophecy just by coming out on the street and preaching this word, man. Read on.
Behold, I will send for many fishers, say the Lord, and they shall fish them.
Yeah, they shall fish them. Who's we going to fish? Yeah, we're going to fish the elect. The one-third of Israel that's going to get this word. Because only one-third of Israel is the true believers of this word. And the Lord already got the number sealed on who's going to make it or not. But at the same time, prophecy still got to be fulfilled. So we out here, the Lord set us up out here to preach and wake up the one-third so that we can get this thing rolling, man. That's what we're here for. Read on.
And after, with our sent for many hunters, and they shall hunt them.
Yeah, that's the same. Matter of fact, here, read that again.
All right. Behold, I will send for many fishers, saith the Lord, and they shall fish them.
Yeah.
And after will I send for many hunters.
Yeah.
And they shall hunt them.
That's right. Now, what's that talking about? That's talking about the prophets that's out here fishing for the elect. The Lord said he's going what?
And they shall hunt them.
We shall hunt them. So after the fun and games is over, the talking out here and trying to preach and get through to y'all brothers, once that number is sealed, the Lord's going to turn us into hunters, like the scripture the brother just read. He said we're going to turn into hunters. And what does hunters do? Hunters go out, they go out to hunt, to kill. So that's what the Lord is going to have us do. Man, he's going to have us going out there and killing the rest of you people who couldn't get this word. When we've been out here fishing for the elect, and once the elect is sealed and they got this truth already, the Lord's going to turn us into hunters, and there ain't nothing else to talk about.
Right. He's not coming. Okay, he's not gonna put the spirit on the Lord's prophets to come and run around in Halloween costumes like you niggas are doing.
Yeah, right.
It's just like as the spirit was bringing out earlier in Proverbs 1, scripture said, "How long ye simple ones? How long will you love simplicity?" That means that you love doing everything that's simple. You love doing everything that's good, that's attracting to the eye, that's appealing. Okay, but you have no wisdom according to the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of the Most High. Now, what you're going to do is you're going to die in America, okay? Because that's the judgment upon you two-thirds for doing what you do in America. That's why on this satanic, demonic-ass day that you know as Halloween, which is a so-called high holy day for the elites, okay, satanic day for the elites, right now this whole thing is under a wicked vibration, okay? Y'all niggas out here, you dressing up as ghouls, dressing up as fucking cross-dressers.
Demons.
You're dressing up as demons. You're doing all this simplicity. That's simplicity to the Most High. You have no wisdom. And what is wisdom? If I could just read the scripture. Can I read the scripture? Yeah. Wisdom of Solomon 6:12. I'm going to read down because it's a lot of good stuff. Wisdom is glorious and never fadeth away. Well, is Halloween glorious to the Most High? Hell no. Is there wisdom in Halloween? Hell no, not on the Most High's behalf. Maybe on Satan's behalf, because what? You're paying homage to wickedness. Wisdom is glorious, okay? Righteous wisdom. Yea, she is easily seen of them that love her. You niggas out here upholding whole Halloween, you don't love the Most High, because wisdom comes.